हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज रोहित धोड़ी। टुडे डॉट टॉपिक माय प्रेजेंटेशन परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल। डेफिनेशंस अकॉर्डिंग टू एडविन बी फिपो, परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल इज अ सिस्टमेटिक पेरिडोसिक एंड सो फार एज ह्यूमनली पॉसिबल एंड इंटर इन पार्टियल रेटिंग ऑफ एन एम्प्लॉइज एक्सलेंट इन matters pertaining to his present job and so his potentials for a better job. Purpose of performance appraisal. Performance appraisal helps the management to take decision about the salary increase of an employee. The conditions evaluation of an employee helps in improving the quality of an employee in job performance. The performance appraisal brings out the facility available to an employee when the management is prepared to provide adequate facilities for effective performance. Objective appraisal to determine the effectiveness of employees on their present jobs so as to decide their benefits, to identify the shortcomings of employees so as to overcome them through systematic guidance and training, to find out their potential to promotion and advancement. Principle of performance appraisal. Single employee is rated by two rates, continuous and personal observation of an employee is essential to make effective performance appraisal. The rating should be done by an immediate superior of any subordinate in an organization. A separate department may be created for effective performance appraisal. Type of performance appraisal: PET comparison method, ranking method, third is forced choice method, fourth is checklist, fifth is grading, force distribution method, 7th last, 360 degree feedback. Pair comparison method. Paired comparisons method has been developed to be used in a big organization. Each employee in compared with the employees taking only one at a time. The evaluator compares two employees and puts a tick mark against an employee whom he considers better employee. Ranking method. An employee is ranked against the other with working groups under this method. Force choice method. B series of group of statement are preferred positively or negatively. Under this method, both these statements describe the objectives of an employee, but the rater is forced to tick any one of the statement either out of positive statement or out of negative statements. Checklist. The appraisal of ability of an employee through grading answer for a number of questions is called the method of checklist. These questions are related to the behavior of an employee. For example, is the employee satisfied with the job? Yes or no? Grading. Certain categories of abilities or performance much of employees are depends well is advanced to fall in certain graders under this method. Such graders are very good average, poor and very poor. Here the individual traits and characteristics are identified. First, distribution method. A method which forces the rater to distribute the rating of the overall performance of an employee is known as forced distribution method. Group wise rating is done under this method. This method is suitable to large organizations, but individual traits could not be appraised under this method. Example: a group of workers doing the same job would fall into the same group as superior, at and above average, below average, and poor. 360-degree feedback. It is a technique which systematic collection of performance data on an individual group derived from a number of stakeholders like immediate supervisors and team members, customer peers, and self. This technique is highly useful in terms of broader perspective, greater self development, and multi source feedback is useful. 360-degree appraisal are useful to measure interpersonal skills, customer satisfaction, and team building skills. Easy evaluation. With easy evaluation technique, the owner's measure is required to describe the employee performance over the entire evaluation period by written narrative deadline. The strength and weakness of the appraisal. Thank you.